Hello students, welcome to the session of divisibility tests. Now I am going to explain exercise problem. Exercise 3.3, third sum. Using divisibility tests, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 6. I think you well known about the divisibility rule. What is the rule for 6? Divisibility rule for 6, we have to that condition is satisfied divisibility by 2 and divisibility by 3. That time only the divisibility by 6 rule is satisfied. Okay, so we have to check the given value first divisible by 2. Then we have to check the given value is divisible by 3. That time only we have to tell the given value is divisible by 6 or not. Okay, what is our given value? First subdivision 297144. Just check the ending value, that is unit digit place value is 4 only. The ending number is an even number. So this number is divisible by 2. So 297144 is divisible by 2. Next we have to check the rule for 3. What is the rule for 3? Sum of the digits is divisible by 3. The whole value is divisible by 3. That time only we have to tell the given value is divisible by 6. Okay. First we have to check. Okay. Given number 297144. Okay. First, the unit digit is, the final value is 4 only. Okay. It is divisible by 2. Directly we have to write, it is divisible by 2. First condition is over. Next we have to check this value is divisible by 3 or not. How can we check? We have to sum of digits. What is the value? 297144. So 2 plus 9 plus 7 plus 1 plus 4 plus 4. Add the values. 2 plus 9, 11. 11 plus 7, 18. Plus 1, 19. Plus 4, 23. Plus 4, 27. Okay. Actually 27 by 3. 3 ones are 3 nines are. So the number 27 is divisible by 3. So automatically the number 297144 is divisible by 3. Okay. Finally we have to write the given number is 297144 is divisible by 6. Have you understand? First we have to check the given value is divisible by 2. Then we have to check the given value is divisible by 3. Then only we have to tell the given number is divisible by 6. Next is subdivision B. 901352. That is our given number. First we have to check the given value is divisible by 2 or not. Then we have to check the given value is divisible by 3 or not. Then only we have to tell the whole value is divisible by 6. Okay. First we have to check the unit digit value. What is the ending value here? That is 2. So unit digit is 2. So it is divisible by 2. Okay. Next we have to check the given value is divisible by 3. So we have to calculate sum of the digits. What is the value? 901352. So 9 plus 0 plus 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 2. Add the values. 9 plus 0, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 plus 5, 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 is not divisible by 3. So the given value is not divisible by 3. It is not divisible by 3. So the given whole value is not divisible by 6. Therefore, 901352 is not divisible by 6. Here we have two conditions. First condition is we have to check the divisibility by 2, then we have to check divisible by 3. If any one condition is not satisfied, the whole value is not divisible by 6. Okay. Next problem. Using divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 11. Given question is very important, because here we are going to use divisibility test by 11. What is the rule for divisibility by 11? To check the divisibility of a number by 11, first find the difference between the sum of the digits at odd places from the right and sum of the digits at even places from the right of the number. If the difference is either 0 or divisible by 11, then the number is divisible by 11. First is subdivision 7138965. We are going to check the given value is divisible by 11 or not. Okay. Given number is 7138965. First we have to add the sum of the digits at odd places. Odd place means first place, third place, fifth place and seventh place. Okay. So sum of the digits at odd places. Okay, what is the value? First value 5 plus 9 plus 3 plus 7. What is the value? 7 plus 3, 10. 10 plus 9, 19. 19 plus 5, 24. Next, we have to check sum of the digits at even places. Even places are 2nd, 4th and 6th. 2nd place value is 6, 4th place value is 8 and the 6th place value is 1. 6 plus 8, 14. 14 plus 1, 15. Now we have to find the difference between sum of the digits at odd places and sum of the digits at even places. Okay. So the difference is equal to 24 minus 15. What is the value? 24 minus 15, that is 9. If difference is either 0 or 11 only, divisibility by 11 condition. Otherwise, it is not divisible by 11. Okay. Difference is either 0 or divisible by 11 is divisibility condition. Otherwise, it is not divisible by 11. Therefore, the given value is not divisible by 11. Next is subdivision. The value is 10824. We are going to check the given value is divisible by 11 or not. First, we have to calculate the sum of odd digits at odd places. Odd place means first place, third place and fifth place. Okay. Sum of digits at odd places. First value is 4 plus 8 plus 1. What is the answer? 8 plus 1, 9. 9 plus 4, 13. Next. Sum of digits at even places. Even place means second place and fourth place value. So 0 plus 2 is equal to 2. Now we have to calculate the difference between odd place and even place. 13 minus 2, that is 11. Difference is either 0 or divisible by 11. That time only the given value is divisible by 11. Now we get the answer 11. Okay. Therefore, it is divisible by 11. Next problem, using divisibility test, determine which of the following numbers are divisible by 5 and 10. What are the rules for 5 and 10? The ending number is 5 or 0, the number is divisible by 5. The ending number is 0 only, that time only the value is divisible by 10. So for 5, we have to see the final number is 5 or 0, ending number. Divisible by 10 means the ending number is 0 only, that condition satisfied. Okay. Now the given value first subdivision is 275. The ending number is actually 5. So it is divisible by 5. Okay. Unit digit value is 5. So it is divisible by 5. But it is not divisible by 10. Because it is not, ending number is 0, no. So it is not divisible by 10. Next, second subdivision is 639210. Check the unit digit place value. That is 0 only. So it is divisible by 5. The ending number is 0, so it is satisfy the condition for 10 also. Okay. Unit digit is 0. So it is divisible by 5. And 10 also. Ending number is 5. It is divisible by 5. Ending number is 0. It satisfies the condition for 5 and 10. Because for 5, you have to see the ending number is 0 or 5. That time only the number is divisible by 5. Divisibility test for 10, the ending number is must 0 only. That time only the given number is divisible by 10.